Hello and welcome to WP Beginner. In this video, I'll walk you through how you can add a signature or an advertisement after your post content in your WordPress website. By default, adding something after the content is not the easiest thing to do. But don't worry, I'll show you two methods to use and I'll tell you which one is my favorite. So if you're ready, let's get started. To get started, log into your website and from your dashboard, let's head over to the plugins area. For the first method, we'll be adding a plugin, and this is my favorite method because it's easy. You don't need to know any code. We merely are searching for a plugin called, insert post ads, and this is the one we want. So we'll click install now and then activate it. Once it's installed, we get this new area over here. I'll take you to the settings first. And from the settings, you want to decide where you want it to be displayed. We're going to pick just posts. So I'll save that setting. And then down here, by default, the post ads are wrapped in a container, as you see it says here. But a developer may want to exclude that. For most people, you just want to leave that as it is. Now that we've set it up to be on posts, let's go ahead and create a new one. So I'm going to click add new. And you can call this whatever you want. It's beneficial for you. You'll be the only one that sees it. Down here is where you can choose where to put it. You can either put it before the content, so it would basically be after the title, but before the content. You can go after the content, so after your last paragraph, it'll come in after that. Or you can choose a paragraph number. This is great for when you're adding ads, and say with Google AdSense, you're only allowed a certain number of ads, and you want to put it in maybe a little bit below the fold. You can choose to add the advertisement after the second paragraph of all your posts. Since I'm adding a signature, I want to make sure that I put it after the content. And in here, this is where you'll put the code. If you're adding an advertisement, then you'll have the code from your publisher or say like Google AdSense. You'll get that code from them. For me, I'm just adding a signature. So I'll add this information with the image source, and then we can click publish. Then I'm going to go up here, right click on visit site. I want to open it in a new window to see what it looks like. I can click on one of the blog posts and you scroll down to after the content. And that is the very fancy signature that I've added. Incidentally, this same signature is added to all of the posts. The second method involves adding this piece of code to your functions.php page. And then you'll want to customize this part right here, which will be specific to your website. The reason why I recommend using the plugin is if you switch a theme, then this will go away. So you'll have to do it again. Whereas having a plugin, it'll stay with you even if you switch out themes. Did you learn something helpful from today's video? If so, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button right here. And thanks for watching.